Good morning, children. How are you? I hope you are doing best. Today, before that, I'll ask one small question, children. If you anyone ask you how many books are there in your bag, then what you will do? Yes, you start counting. Okay, what are the numbers you use for counting? Yes, you use 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. These are the numbers you use for counting. What we call these numbers? Yes, these are counting numbers. Other than counting numbers, what is the word we use? Yes, these are known as natural numbers. Natural numbers are represented by the letter capital N. Here N indicates that they are natural numbers. Natural numbers set start with 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on up to infinite. That is, smallest natural number is 1. And the largest natural number doesn't exist. They are infinite. Okay, children, natural numbers are infinite. Then next, to the natural number set, if we add 0 to the natural number set, then we get new set. Okay, we call them as whole number set. Whole number set is represented by the letter capital W. In this set, we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on up to infinite. Here, smallest whole number is 0 and the largest whole number doesn't exist. Okay, children, now these are our whole number set. Smallest whole number is 0 and the largest whole number is doesn't exist. Now, can I say all natural numbers are whole numbers? Natural numbers are what? 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to infinite. All natural numbers are whole numbers. Natural numbers are there in the whole number set. But all whole numbers are not natural numbers because 0 is a whole number but 0 is not there in the natural number set. Now here simply we can say that natural number set is smaller than whole number set. Now next, now here what we came to know, natural number set is smaller than whole number set. Now whole numbers are what? 0 and natural numbers together we call them as whole number set. Now today we are going to learn a new set called integer set. Integer set is represented by the letter I or Z. I or Z. In this set we have all positive numbers or negative numbers including 0. That is minus 3, for example, minus 2, minus 1, 0, okay, 1, 2, 3 and so on. In this set we have all negative numbers, 0 and all positive numbers are there in this whole number set. This is integer set is represented by the letter I or Z. Now here, in this integer set, that is by adding 1 to the integer minus 3, we add 1, we get minus 2. Minus 2, if we add 1, we get minus 1. That is by adding the previous, that is predecessor 1, if we add, we get the successor. Now here, by writing the numbers, okay, you know already natural numbers, how to write the 1, 2, 3 and so on. That is, we write from smaller number to bigger number. Here also minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0 and so on if you are writing. If by observing this set, we came to know that this set here extending on either side. That is, in this set we doesn't have smallest, that is smallest integer does not exist as well as largest integer also does not exist. That is, there is no smallest integer and there is no largest integer. That is, here, now if you want to compare these numbers, okay, now once again I write the integer set, that is whole numbers I am writing for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to infinite, and integer set I or Z. equal to the. Now next term, in this integer set we have -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on up to infinite. If you want to compare this integers, first of all let's take you know already how to compare 1 and 2. Okay, here 2 is greater, that is 2 is greater than 1. Now that is in integer set, right hand side numbers are greater than the left side numbers. 2 is greater than 1. Similarly, if you want to compare 0 and 1, if you are comparing here, always 1 is greater than 0. Okay, 1 is greater than 0, 2 also greater, that is here these all numbers are greater than 0, that is 0 is smaller than all positive integers. Then next, if you want to compare negative integer and 0, that is -1 and 0, if you want to compare here, minus 1 is smaller than 0, that is negative numbers here, -1 is there here left hand side, 0 is there right hand side, that is why 0 is greater, right hand side numbers are greater than the left hand side numbers. Similarly, minus 2 is there here left side than 0, minus 2 is smaller than 0. Similarly, minus 3 is also smaller than 0. Is what you came to know here, 0 is greater than all negative numbers. Now here if you want to compare two negative numbers, for example minus 3 and minus 2, if you are comparing here, which one is right hand side, which one lies right hand side, minus 2, that is minus 2 is greater than minus 3. Okay, that is right hand side number is greater, that is the numbers which are closer to 0, which are approaching to 0 are greater numbers. Now -91 and -203. See, 91 and 203 positive numbers, if they are positive 203 is greater, if they are negative it is reverse. Minus 91 is greater. Why? Because minus 91 is closer to 0. This is how we will compare the negative numbers. Okay children, I think comparison is clear to you. And how to mark the integers on the number line also, first we will mark 0. And right side of the 0 we will mark the positive numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, and left side of the 0 we mark negative numbers, -1, -2, -3 and so on up to infinite. Numbers are here infinite, negative numbers are infinite as well as positive numbers are infinite, and here largest negative number is -1 is the largest negative number, and here smallest positive number is 1. Here 0 is neither positive nor negative. It won't come under either negative number set or positive number set. Now next, now do you know children where we use these negative numbers to indicate, that is to represent the loss? Suppose in a business there is a loss 200 rupees. Now to represent the loss we use negative number, that is -200. To indicate the loss we use the negative number. Similarly, in some states in our country also temperature is less than 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, that is -2 degrees, -4 degrees, -6 degrees. Either to represent the temperature, cold temperatures to represent, here we use negative numbers. We also use negative numbers to represent the past periods of time, 3 days back, rupa, variant, euros. Okay, past periods of time to represent, we use negative numbers. As well as here, suppose here there is this sea level is here, height is 0. Now above the sea level, a bird is flying above the sea level, 25 meters. Okay, right, a bird is flying above the sea level here. So next term, below the sea level there is a fish. It is, for example, it is 2 meters. 2 meters below the sea level there is a fish. That is to represent the depth we use the negative number. Where is the fish? It is 2 meters below the sea level, that is -2 meters. and where is the cloud? It is 25 meters above the sea level, plus 25 meters. Okay, that is to represent the depth. We use the these negative numbers. We use these are the uses of the negative numbers. Okay, children. The next we will see how to add and how to subtract the integers on the number line. But before that, we should simplify the integers. For example, 2 + -3. But is there question? If we simplify, if we write only one symbol, then easily we can represent it on the number line. So simplify plus in bracket indicates into here multiplication, plus into minus, or plus into plus, minus into minus. What is the symbol we get? First of all, we should know. For that, you remember this table model. Okay, that is plus in k. Now plus into plus plus into plus gives plus. Okay, that is plus into plus gives plus. Now plus into minus it gives minus. Now minus into plus it gives minus again, and minus into minus that gives plus. Okay, if there are two symbols, always product of two positive integers is positive, product of positive and negative integers is negative, negative and positive integers is also negative. But two negative integers if we multiply, we get a positive integer. Now we use this one by simplifying. For example, -2 + -3 is the question. Okay, then how we simplify this one? This is -2 as it is, will write. Why? Because before the bracket, if there we are imagining that there is a plus sign. Now plus into minus that gives minus, and again plus into minus that gives minus. That is, if we simplify this question, the question is -2 and -3. -2 - -3. This is the question. Then next another example, 4 - +3. 4 - +3. That is 4. Minus into plus gives minus. Minus into plus gives minus. Minus into plus gives minus. Plus into minus. Plus into minus also it gives minus. Let's take another example. Now -6. Now -4. Now what is minus into minus, children? Minus into minus is plus. That is -6 + 4. Like this, first we should simplify. First we have to open the bracket and we'll simplify. After that, we'll mark the number line. Let's see one number line problem now. -2 + -6. This is the question. Now first, as I said already, open the brackets. Then the question is -2 - -6. Now we should find -2 - -6 value using number line. First, draw one number line. Mark the integers. First, mark middle number 0, and right hand side you mark positive numbers. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And left side you mark negative numbers. That is -1, -2, -3. Now here, what is the first number? First number is -2. We have to start from which number? We should start from -2. And if it is negative sign, in middle if it is a negative sign, on number line, we should move to the left hand side. If it is a positive sign, right hand side. Why? Because if it is positive, the number value is increasing. Increasing means the number value increases means bigger numbers are there in right hand side. If it is negative symbol, we have to move to the on number line, we should move towards the left side. Now start from minus 2, that is from 0. First go to minus 2. After that take 6 steps back. That is toward the left side, take 6 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Toward the left hand side, take 6 steps. Then you reach to minus 8. That is minus 2 and minus 6. Value is how much? It is minus 8. Let's take another sum. Minus 3 plus of minus 2. As I said already, first open the brackets, then you will get minus 3 plus into minus, that is minus 2. The value is what? Minus 3, minus 2. Same like the previous problem only. First draw the number line. Write the numbers, positive numbers, right hand sides. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, they are negative only. We require negative numbers more. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. Minus 5, minus 6, and so on. Now, here we should first start from 0. We should move towards the left side, 3. That is, we should reach first minus 3. 3 steps back. From there again, it is negative symbol. We should move toward the left side. 2 steps back we should take. Then we reach to minus 5. Therefore, minus 3, minus 2 value is how much? It is minus 5. Minus 4, minus of plus 3. Let's take this time plus of. Okay. That is, first open the brackets. Minus 4 plus into plus, plus 3. Minus 4 plus 3. Now first draw the number line. Here it is 0. Then next, right hand side write the positive numbers and left hand side write the negative numbers. First start from 0, first reach to minus 4 and after that, okay, plus 3. 3 steps take toward the right side. 3 steps, 1 from minus 4, 3 steps toward the right side you have to take. Then you reach to minus 1. Minus 4 plus 3 gives minus 1. What is the answer? Minus 1. Now let's take another example. Minus 3 minus of minus 2. Here also. First write minus 3, now minus into minus gives plus 2. The question is minus 3 plus 2. First draw the number line. Positive numbers mark right hand side. And negative numbers mark left side. First start from 0. First start from 0 and reach to minus 3. We reach to minus 3. After that addition. Addition means on number line we should move right hand side. How many steps? 2 steps. Then we reach to minus 1. Minus 3 plus 2 value is minus 1. Okay children, this is how we will do the integer simplification on the number line. Now without using number line, how to find their values, we will see now. Minus 4 plus of minus 5, this value we want without using number line. First open the brackets, then you get minus 4 plus into minus is minus, minus 5. Now for example, minus sign indicates it is the loss. 4 rupees somebody taken from you, 5 rupees taken total. How many rupees taken? Total how many rupees taken? 9 rupees taken. That is total 9 rupees loss. That is if you add two negative numbers, we should add total is a negative number always. Okay, 4 rupee loss, 5 rupee loss. Total 9 rupee loss. Loss is here indicated by the symbol minus, negative symbol. Minus 3 minus of plus 4. First minus 3 minus into plus minus 4. Now here also minus 3 rupee loss, 4 rupee loss. Total 7 rupee loss, that is minus 7. Total loss is minus 7. Now 8 minus of minus 2. That is 8. Now minus into minus. Minus of minus 2, that is minus into minus. Minus into minus is plus. 8 plus 2. The question is here 8 plus 2. 8 rupees given, 2 rupees given. You know already the total is 10. Now minus 4 plus of minus 7. Okay. First open the brackets, minus 4 plus into minus is minus 7. Total is loss here, 4 rupees taken, 7 rupees taken. Total there is a loss, that is how many rupees? 7 and 4 if you add, then you will get 11. 11 rupees loss. If both are negative, minus sign. If both are positive, plus sign. Now we will see one minus a number and one plus number. Minus 3 plus of minus, okay, plus 5. Minus 3 plus of plus 5. If this is the question, then minus 3 plus into plus plus 5. Minus 3 plus 5. Now here 3 rupees taken but 5 rupees given. We got a profit. How many rupees profit? That is 5 minus 3. That is 2 rupees profit. That is plus 2. Generally we won't represent plus. Plus 2 or 2 both indicates same. Generally we won't write positive symbol. It is minus 3 plus 5. 3 rupees taken but 5 given. There is a profit. How many rupees profit? 2 rupees. Now minus 9 plus of plus 4. That is minus 9 plus into plus plus 4. Here 9 rupees taken, 4 rupees given. Here there is a loss. How many rupees loss here? That is 9 minus 4. If you subtract, then you will get 5. 5 rupees loss. That is if one positive number, one negative number, if it is there, we should do subtraction. 9 and 4 subtract. Difference is 5. Now bigger number 9 is having minus sign. That is there is a loss more. Therefore minus. Bigger number symbol we write here. Now next we will see how to simplify the numbers if more than two digits are there. For example, minus 3 plus of minus 2, minus of minus 7 and minus of minus 3. Okay. If this is the question, then how we will simplify the integers. First we will open the brackets, that is minus 3. Now plus into minus is minus 2, minus into minus is plus 7 and minus into minus is plus 3. Okay. Now here negative numbers is one group, positive numbers another group. First negative numbers find out the total. How many are there negatives total here? Total 5 are there, minus 5, and total positive numbers are 10. 7 plus 3 is 10. First, open the bracket. First step is open the brackets and second one, group the negative numbers as well as positive numbers together. Then simplify the negative numbers. Then we came to know total negative numbers are 5 and total positive numbers are 10. So, one positive number, one negative numbers always do the subtraction. If you subtract 10 minus 5, the question is 10 minus 5. 5 rupees taken but 10 rupees given, there is a profit, plus symbol. Bigger number is 10, having plus sign, here we get a plus symbol. Now find out the difference, 10 minus 5, it is 5, answer is plus 5, or generally we write 5, answer is 5. Let's take another sum, minus 13, minus of minus 2, plus of minus 4. 4 and minus of plus 3. Here also, first what we have to do, we should open the brackets, then we will get minus 13. Now minus into minus, it is plus 2. Now plus into minus, it is minus 4. And minus into plus, it is minus 3. Now negative numbers, first write them together. Then you will get minus 13, minus 4, minus 3. All negative numbers group together. Then write the positive number, that is plus 2. Find out the sum of the negatives. 13 plus 4, it is 17. 17 and plus 3, it is 20. Minus 20. Sum of the negative numbers is minus 20. And then write plus 2. Minus 20 plus 2. Now here 20 rupees taken and 2 rupees given. There is a loss. That is, negative numbers are more, then we get a loss. There is a loss. Loss indicated by here minus sign. Now 20 and 2, find out the difference. 20 and 2, find out the difference here. Difference is 18. Now negative numbers are more. 20 is negative number. Bigger number is negative number. Answer is also a negative number. Okay, there is a loss here, that is 18. Answer is minus 18. Okay, finally we'll see one more problem. Minus 30 plus of minus 80 plus of plus 40 and minus of 20. Okay, let's simplify this. First open the brackets, that is first number minus 30 as it is. Now plus into minus is minus 18 and plus into plus is plus 40. Then minus, here there is no symbol, means that is plus. Minus into plus, that is minus 20. First open the brackets like this. After that, group the numbers together, that is negative numbers group together. Here 3 are the negative numbers, write them together, that is minus 30, minus 80, minus 20. Write the negative numbers together and then write positive number, that is plus 40. Now simplify, add all the negatives. Okay, then 80 plus 20 is 100, 100 plus 30 is 130, total negative numbers are 130. Total is 130. Now positive number only one, that is 40, right? Now finally negative numbers and positive numbers, you do the subtraction. Okay, that is 130. From 130 you have to subtract 40. 130 minus 40, that gives here 90. Now which symbol we get for 90? Plus symbol or minus symbol? Here 130 is bigger number. Bigger number is having minus sign, that is minus. Total there is a loss. 130 rupees here taken and 40 given, there is a loss. Loss is indicated by here minus sign. Answer is minus 90. This is how we simplify the integers. Okay. In this video, what we have learned? What are natural numbers? What are whole numbers? Okay. After that, integers. Integers, it is represented which letter? It is represented by the letter I or Z. In integer set, we have all positive numbers, all negative numbers, including 0. 0 is neither positive nor negative. And small, what is the largest negative number? Yes, largest negative number is minus 1. Smallest negative number does not exist. And smallest positive number is 1. Positive number smaller is 1. Largest positive number also does not exist here. Smallest and largest number does not exist. After that, you know already where we use these negative numbers. We use negative numbers to represent the loss, loss in a business, or depth of the sea level, to represent the depth, temperatures below 0 degree Celsius. For all this we use negative numbers. And how to represent the negative numbers on the number line also we have seen. Okay, children, thank you.